Hey, Tyler, I got a surprise for you.
What?
It's Transistor.
It's Transistor?
Hey, Red. Yeah.
We're not is that sword talking? This,
are we? That is a sword talking.
Damn.
Game starts fast.
Come on. Am I the girl?
You are the girl.
There. Or am I the sword?
You're the girl.
Oh, shit. Let's break this box.
So,
I'm gonna break the box. I love this game. The arrow wants me to go that way.
Yeah. So this game, made by the developers of one of our favorite games, Bastion.
Yeah.
Fantastic art style, great music direction, excellent story. It's just they're good at making games.
They're good at making games. I gotta agree on that one.
So I've beaten Transistor, but you haven't had a chance to play it yet.
No. Oh, I was supposed to hit A. They want
back. One thing I love is even though we're playing on PC, they automatically adapt the commands to whatever controller you're using. Nice. Okay. And if you remember from Bastion, they had the narrator talking all the time. In this case, the sword kind of talks to you.
Nice.
The sword / computer chip thing.
All my attacks are kind of slow. Oh, what's going on?
So this here is like the Transistor mode, where time stops and you plan out a series of moves and then you execute it. Then you press RT.
Wait, how do I enter that?
I don't remember. It might be RT. Not yet. You have to wait for it to recharge. Yep. So that bar on the top is how much time you can put into the program. And then you execute. So all your moves are programs, technically, and the penalty you have for dying in Transistor is that if you die, one of your programs gets taken away.
Oh.
Until you make it to the next save point.
Damn.
If you keep dying in a place, you could end up with no programs and essentially kind of soft lock yourself.
Hey, up there.
Suppose there's ways out of it. I didn't find myself in an issue where I couldn't progress, although there was one time that I got pretty close.
I just love the fact that I dragged the sword.
Hey, do you want to press pause real quick? Let's go ahead and turn subtitles on. Down to settings. It's somewhere in there. Hey, there they are.
Let's look in this telescope. Damn, yeah. That's
a city.
Fun fact. Still too close to it. I drew that.
Really? You drew that?
I drew that, yeah.
Are you pointing to the screen or the stick figures on the wall behind it?
I think I speak for myself when I said I drew that. You don't need to make fun of me, man.
I'm asking a question, bro. I do not mean to insinuate anything by it.
You and your insinuating.
Insinuation.
So when I go into that RT, right, I gotta charge, like, before I can even attack anything, so I just gotta run around like a little bitch?
Not necessarily.
Not like, necessarily, yeah. It's exactly it. You
okay? No, it depends on if you've already used the ability. Like, each of your abilities have their own cooldown.
What?
It's, think of like playing League. See, now that person, every person is also a program in Transistor, and so you found a dead lady. And her program has come with you. So now if you press X, you've got this...
These bombs.
Yeah, this cluster bomb sort of thing.
Hey, end of the plaza. It's you.
Hey. It's a poster.
I'm so sorry, Red.
Hey, I'm Red. Well, we're riding her.
Well, I mean, something like that. I couldn't stop that. Our protagonist here, she's like a famous singer. And there was a tragedy that happened earlier in the night. Where during her performance, and she's been, well, you'll figure it out. I don't think that last one hit.
That's cool. Can I cancel this? I can't cancel it.
No, once you execute it, you can't cancel.
Nope, I missed. God, I'm bad.
I wonder if it's not automatically going to wherever the mouse is for aiming.
I don't think so.
You don't think so?
Yeah.
Okay, because it just looks like it's always going the same way. You know what I'm saying?
It always, like, it always kind of starts off the same, but I control it pretty well. No, I want... Why do I have to undo that last action?
I think it's just a tutorial thing. Like, you can do it again and then just execute.
Oh, give me these. Oh, these cells. Oh.
So the cells, if you don't collect them, they turn into enemies again.
Gross.
But, so I played this game. I think I beat it in like 3 or 4 hours. Maybe 5 hours. But that was pretty much just a straight blitz of the game.
Blitz, bonsai blitz.
Yeah, it was sweet.
Breakpoint. Come closer. Let's go on this one.
I don't remember what to do here.
That wasn't it.
Press A. I don't see why that worked, but okay.
It made sense, you know, I go kind of faster.
Yeah. We haven't recorded anything in a while, you and I.
Yeah, it's because I quit.
Since, you know, 7 minutes into the video, this is probably a good time to mention that we got Tanner and Tyler here playing Transistor together. Tanner, Tyler, Transistor. Should we call this series T-Cubed?
I like Bro Play.
Bro Play? Bro Play. So, Jaunt, I think it's like a dash that you can just... It never has a cooldown.
Oh, whoa, wait. You're telling me my X, I could, like, aim it and shoot?
Yeah.
She's dope, man.
You crash through those. This is definitely a different kind of battle system from anything I've seen before in games. Because it's both turn-based and action-based. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I think Dragon Age Inquisition did something similar, where you could go into tactical mode, which was kind of like a top-down version, but still was, I don't know, it still was played primarily, at least for me, in just real-time, over-the-shoulder sort of stuff.
Level 2!
So you get a pick between these two functions as you level up. You can get Bounce, which by itself just kind of bounces an ability. Use the control stick. What about RBLB? Well, I guess that's what we'll pull in the, or you can get... Mask, which is like a stealth, and if you use it, like you can combine functions together,
uh-huh.
And if you put it on something, it uses the potency of it, that function when you're doing a backstab.
Fuck it, let's take Mask. I don't care. I don't even remember what the other one was, but...
It caused things to bounce.
I don't care.
All right.
Yeah. You know, some people say I need a mask.
No, I think you've got a great face for radio. It's a face.
No, you see, they're not saying that I'm ugly. They're just saying that I'm not good looking.
I can see how people would confuse those things.
Okay, so wait, what am I...
So go over to Mask, press A, and then choose a function type to upgrade. You can put it in the first slot of any of your abilities. What do you want to be your backstab move?
It makes sense for it to be this one.
Is that the faster one?
Good.
Yeah.
Just one more block. I want to show you something.
Yeah. Oh my
cool.
God. All right, you want to see my speedrunning strats here?
Speedrun strats?
Just hitting Y, man. You go faster?
Yeah, just gotta run. Gotta go fast. But as far as like what the enemies are, the process, I'm not too sure. Like I said, I played through this real quick. so I didn't spend a whole lot of time.
I want to just look for... Ah, fuck it. Ah, no, it didn't hit him. We're going to go back, back. We're going to get closer.
Nice. Ooh, overkill. You
what?
Know,
I missed. No, I got him. That's cool.
So another game I thought about us playing together, Ty.
Yeah.
Or at least going through together was Final Fantasy 15.
Beat the shit out of that game already.
Yeah, I know you did. I haven't touched it yet. Yet, I'll get to it. I promise. But I thought maybe, just maybe, a Final Fantasy game wasn't the best to do. Because we either have to make a bajillion and a half parts to get through it, or we just stop midway through. And I didn't like either of those.
Yeah.
But since you've played through it recently, what'd you think?
Yeah, it was pretty good.
How does it compare to other Final Fantasies?
It's got a completely different battle system, so it's hard to kind of compare it to. But story-wise, it wasn't the greatest, in my opinion.
Okay.
But then again, I haven't played a whole lot of Final Fantasies.
So, would you say it was like...
They're gone.
Not the greatest story, is that like from a plot standpoint, a character standpoint?
Well, for a Final Fantasy game, it seemed kind of short to me.
Okay. Yeah, they are typically known for being pretty long. I have no idea what you're doing there.
Oh, there's an access point here. I don't know what I'm going to this for.
I think it heals you, and it saves when you use it.
My biggest problem with it was it eventually just kind of bottlenecked you into the story, it seemed like. Mostly because I couldn't figure out how to go back for a while. I had to Google it. But it was good. I enjoyed it. I'm still playing through it quite a bit, trying to get all the achievements.
Yeah, how close are you?
I'm missing 4 or 5. I'm missing 5.
Out of how many?
Like 30.
Okay. So how many of those are like main story?
Wait, I'm missing 6.
How many are... Like if you just play through the main game...
You'll get a vast majority of them.
Okay. So not too bad.
No.
Yeah, you can press A to accelerate.
You gotta mash it?
I think you hold it. I don't know if that's true or not, I'm guessing.
I feel like that sword is like the Toonami guy.
Oh, Tom?
Yeah.
From Toonami?
Yeah.
Those were the days. I haven't watched Toonami, like, it's back. It's on Saturday nights at like midnight.
Tanner.
Yeah?
Don't let me go.
I won't. Actually, I might. I don't know what to say. I just said the first thing that... Sorry.
Tanner. Tanner, is this gonna be like the time you shot me?
Ty, do we have to bring that up?
Yeah, I gotta bring it up every opportunity. Because you're a piece of shit.
I know I am. I was young.
It's like 2 weeks ago.
Yeah? That's 2 weeks younger. What, controller's not working? Press start? And it's back working.
That took about 20 minutes, guys. I tell you what.
Like, we had to call into India to tech support.
Yeah.
And they had to give us a routing number to South Korea. It was a whole process. Get it? Process? Because you're fighting the process right now? The process is being a pain? Get it, Tyler? Huh? You get it?
Tanner, of course I get it. I'm not dumb. No, I didn't actually get it at first, but, you know.
Let's go.
It's okay. I'll forgive you.
Does my Y actually do damage?
I don't think it does.
Oh, shit, did he heal?
He probably healed.
Oh, there goes all his health. No, he didn't heal.
Oh, no. Weird. They just made another one?
I want a quicker attack.
You can get him. If you put Jaunt on as a secondary onto an ability, then it has a faster animation and recharge time. Which is pretty cool. So during like the performance, the main character lost her voice, which is why she doesn't say anything. I'm not sure if they've said that at this point or not yet. I haven't been paying the most of attention.
I'm so close to that Tanner.
You can do it, I believe. So do you wanna ask me any games I've been playing? Anything I'm interested in? They were waiting.
Tanner, have I ever been interested in what you're doing?
Well, thanks for asking, Tyler. You see, recently I've played through Dishonored 2.
Yeah, I know. We've raced, remember, and I kicked your ass.
That's not even close to what happened.
I don't know what that does, but I like it.
Yeah, I don't think it does anything, to be honest. It probably does, and I just don't know. But I tried to like combo it into things or something, but I don't think it does anything.
Hunger, grab a bite.
Oh, so this is like a message board. You can like, well, I think this is one of them where you can like actually post, like act as Red and like post on the message boards for her. I think you can go somewhere and actually see what everybody has answered for these things, which is kind of cool.
Oh, that was the end of the... Okay.
Yeah, once those blue lines come up, you can't escape unless you kill all the enemies.
Yeah, I didn't see the blue line.
But back to Dishonored 2. Fantastic game. Very good. Plot-wise, not as strong as the first one, in my opinion. Gameplay, though, was fantastic. Beat through it. Never detected. No kills. No powers.
Because you're a weirdo.
Because I hate myself, apparently. But it was a good time. It was a good time. Still working on going through as Emily and getting all the runes and bone charms.
Let's just get all these.
So that's not your average everyday jerk. That's jerk 2.0.
What are you talking about?
The enemy name. It's Jerk 2.0.
Oh, damn.
See? Jerk 2.0.
Oh, wait. Was that just not? Yeah, it was. Wait, what's... Oh.
You're out of space. Triple breach.
I did a triple breach? I didn't even realize.
I mean, you did three breaches. So the worms, they healed the big guy.
Back off!
I'll take you on. Headstrong, take on anyone. He's healing up.
Wait, no, what are you doing?
I think you want to use bomb. So you can hit the worm. Nice. That looks satisfying. That looked really satisfying. So, have I told you about the time I almost got roped into a pyramid scheme?
Oh, okay.
So I was at Target, you know, as you do.
Uh-huh.
And just kind of kept running into this guy throughout Target and making some small talk with him because he was in my way. And end up being right behind him at the checkout. And... you know, walk out the door at the same time as him. And he says to me, "Hey, you seem like you got pretty good people skills." Which I wanted to believe was true. So he says, "You ever thought about online marketing?" And I say to him, "Well, no, I can't say that I have." He says, "Well, you know, if you're interested, you can do a sit down, and, you know, I won't promise anything, you won't promise anything, you know, just see what there is." I didn't see any harm in it. So, I was like, sure. I give him my phone number, and he gives me a call later in the week. And set up a meeting for, I think it was a Tuesday night, at a hotel. I was supposed to meet him and his mentor at a hotel, like, meeting room. And me being the idiot I am, didn't... didn't put two and two together. But I show up at the meeting room on that Tuesday night while it's raining, and there's a bunch of people there. Like there's it's like a huge event. There's people, you know, dressed in nice clothes, and I'm sitting there in jeans and a leather jacket, right? And so the guy, you know, he meets me, he takes me to you know, introduces me in person to the speaker for the meeting. And everyone's, you know, being real nice and excited. And I sit down, I hear the presentation. And I tell you what, this speaker, this guy, he's a fantastic speaker. I'm sure he can make a legitimate living just being a motivational speaker. I tell you what, it was a scam. The whole thing was a scam. Sat down and he told me all about how you know, these fantastic products that we could sell.
Mm-hmm.
We just had to get the products from them, and then we could sell the products. And if we got more people in, we would get recruitment bonuses.
Okay.
So obviously, the more people you got underneath you, the better bonuses you would get.
Uh-huh.
So while selling the product is, you know, one way of making some money, which you're never going to sell the product. It's incredibly overpriced and nobody's ever heard of it. You know, energy. They tried to sell me on these energy drinks that were supposedly more healthy for you than anything else on the market, which didn't make a lick of sense to me. Because if it was truly a healthy energy drink, I have a feeling it would be all over the market to begin with.
Mm-hmm.
Unless it was ridiculously expensive. This other thing they wanted me to sell was a water that was, how'd they put it? Molecularly engineered to be better for you. They somehow took, you know, water molecules, H2O,
yeah,
one hydrogen, or two hydrogen, one oxygen,
uh-huh, made it better.
And somehow they made that better.
Huh.
Crazy, right? I couldn't believe my ears.
I haven't taken a lot of chemistry courses. Maybe one.
Possibly two.
And I know that doesn't make a lick of sense.
It really doesn't. My favorite part of the night, though, was in this presentation. The guy says, now you could go and you could Google Amway, and you're going to find people saying all sorts of things. But would any of you, would any of you college students, would Googling something be considered acceptable research for an assignment? He says, no, of course not. You'd have to dig deeper than that. And here's the other thing about Google searches, is they'll turn up anything. If you put in Mother Teresa murderer, you're going to get, you know, thousands of hits. I mean, that's just the way the internet works.
So tell me, wait, let me get this straight. I've been schooling wrong? Because trust me, I Googled 100% of my answers.
Well, this is, you know, research papers where you're going to have to actually put down a source, right? Not just, you know, find an answer. The best part after that was immediately, without missing a beat, he then shows a slide of Apple's partnership with Amway, and mentions that, like, oh yeah, we sell, you know, this and this for Apple. And he says, to me, that was all the research I needed. He's just like, are you kidding me? You literally just said that a Google search was not acceptable research, that it needed to be more thorough than that. Then you say, oh, look, I saw an Apple logo and that was enough research for me? Come on!
Yeah, you almost got done, man.
No, I did not almost get done. There was no way that I was participating in this event.
I don't know, Tanner. I've known you a long time. You definitely would have participated in that.
I would not.
You're kind of a moron. I'm not just saying that because I think I would have fallen for it. If that's what you're thinking.
Well, so he goes on and on about how, you know, in life, you know, it seems that you only can pick, you know, time, money, or energy. You can only have two of the three. Well, what if I told you could have all three, and all you had to do was get in on this system? And he just went on and on about having money and time and doing very little work just because.
Dude, Dude, that sounds like my life already. Oh, wait. Oh, no. Why would I do that? I didn't want to be in that thing.
And then, so, afterwards, you know, after the presentation, the guy who had invited me, you know, he asked me, like, well, do you want to go, you know, talk with the speaker some more? I said to him, well, you know, I really appreciate the opportunity, but this, you know, this system sounds like to get the most out of it, I'm going to have to bring more people into this, and I just don't feel comfortable doing that. He says, whoa, whoa, whoa. I mean, we don't see it as bringing people in. We consider it working together. And I just kind of gave him a look, and he was like, yeah, yeah, yeah. So then, immediately, without missing a beat, what do you think he does?
Hey, you made headlines.
He's already found out he's not going to be able to recruit me to sell stuff for him.
Okay, I'm going to guess he takes his pointer finger on his right hand, points at you, points towards the door.
No. He tries to sell me some product. He immediately goes, well, would you like to buy some product? I don't know if I've ever managed to be so angry and stay so civil in my life. Throughout the presentation, I struggled with wanting to just open up and let everyone like in on what's going on here and how this is clearly a pyramid scheme and they're all being duped. But at the same time, it's like I was invited to this meeting. Like, this is a meeting for people who are interested.
Yeah.
This isn't just some casual conversation on the street. Like, if they want to conduct themselves this way, this was not the place for me to argue with them.
So, out of everything I've heard this about this story, you know what's the most surprising thing? Is that this is my first time hearing it.
Really?
Yeah.
The night it happened, I called up Dad to tell him the story. And, you'd never guess, Amway tried to sucker him in when he was younger, too.
Huh.
His boss at the, I think it was either a liquor store or a convenience store that he was working at. His boss was a part of it, and his boss was kind of, yeah, just go ahead and leave it here, we'll stop in just a second. But his boss was a part of it and kind of pressured the other employees into joining the Amway system. Which, there's an entire journal over a bit about pyramid schemes, I recommend just go watching it. It lays it all out better than I can, but it's kind of infuriating.
Yeah.
And mildly amusing.
Yeah.
Yeah. Sorry for dominating this episode with...
Hey, Tanner.
Yeah?
You know I don't speak anyway.
I know. Big stuff next.